everyone. I'm your host, Boss Zombie. Welcome back to Hidden Agenda. Let's resume. So if I go straight through the door and then see the wire cutters, I should be able to save her. That's what I'm thinking, anyways. I'll have more time. And I'll know of a way to... Okay, so... Come on, controls. Okay, so now I know where all the things are.
Search for the clues shown at the top.
Shut
of the
up, tutorial man.
Use your pointer to highlight the clues before the timer runs out. Some of these clues could help you in the future, so try to find them all.
Okay, I know first clue. God, it takes so long for the controls to start responding. There we go. We got the explosives. We got bag. Come on, we got footprints. I mean, why else would they point out wire cutters, right? There's gotta be a way to save this lady. And it's impossible that Marnie dies, right? It wouldn't make it, it's impossible timeline-wise. Pick them up. So she should have more time this time. Hello. I still don't even know who you are. I know your name's Catherine, but that's about it as far as things go. Also, what does she have to do? Did she hire a prostitute, too?
Who did this to you?
I was in the bar. I don't know. I woke up here. Oh, God. Please, help me. Please. What's happening?
I feel like it's the same amount of time, regardless. Help, victim. Help, victim. Help, victim.
Okay, I'm gonna remove the timer.
Oh, God! Oh, my God, get me out of there!
Get the stupid wire cutters. Get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them. Yes, yes. Save her. Save her, save her, save her, save her. Holy shit, I actually did save her. Hey.
It wasn't the kind of thing I'm eager to repeat.
Finn must have seen you coming. Got out before finishing the job.
Yeah, split so quick he left his gear behind.
So we're not going to talk about her? About the Catherine lady?
It was very brave of you to go in there alone.
I was just doing my job.
And how did you link Finn to the scene?
I discovered that Mr. Finn had left a hair at the scene. We ran the DNA.
That's such bullshit. How would you find a single hair in a place like that?
He was already in the system.
Finn had been in and out of the station so many times he practically had a door with his name on it. When we got the tip that he'd been spotted at a squat, we just happened to be driving by.
Shit just seems to fall in your lap, detective.
At least I caught him, Dick.
Uh-oh. Mama Bear's got a temper. Watch out.
Hey.
Okay, let's ease up on the pissing contest, all right? Let's at least try to pretend to work together.
The Trapper case shook everyone up. I think we've poured enough salt in all our own wounds for one night.
Sergeant.
I can't believe I saved her. I'm so happy.
Anything else we can help you with?
All right. I've heard enough. Thank you, everyone, for hearing me out.
And thank you for eating up our entire afternoon with this shit.
God, you just have, like, the perfect chin for that shit-eating grin.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that...
Calvary's a dick.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Okay, this time I need to go with you. Yes.
Hey, what are you doing tonight?
What?
I've got a huge stack of files at my apartment. Not gonna be able to get through it on my own.
Okay, sure. I can help you with that.
Perfect. Call me.
That's still such an awkward moment. I mean, it makes sense, like, in the scheme of things. It's just so weirdly acted. I saved the lady. She won't probably come up again anywhere in the plot, but I saved the lady.
Rat trap.
I didn't even get a trophy for it.
Found one at each of his crime scenes. Some kind of messed up calling card.
I had no idea.
We managed to keep it out of the press. Target number one, Rupert Walsh, the Undertaker. After he killed him, the trapper rigged a shotgun to the motel door, and the officer who got the call took it in the chest. Simple, but messy. Not a guarantee he killed the responder.
Was there anything more on the victim? I mean, he's the only one with
this we've all seen.
Is just a local gin hound.
Finn called it a dry run with a wet noodle. I guess that was his idea of some kind of sick joke. But then again, if he's not the trapper, God damn it. This case is just the gift that keeps on giving.
Ricky, do you want to take a break?
Okay, be nice.
I'm sorry, it's just, this was all ancient history. And staring at these files again, Finn's execution coming up, I don't know, it's been hard to sleep with this shit just running through my head.
Well, the good news is it'll all be over before you know it.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Second target, nasty piece of work.
Oh, this is one that would beat the kids till you couldn't recognize them.
LeMay. Orderly at Las Palmas. A couple years before the orphanage, narcotics had a file on him a mile wide.
But they couldn't get anything to stick.
Slippery son of a bitch. The trapper left his body in a pitch black room, rigged a light fixture with C4. The cop who showed up flipped the light switch and let there be light.
He's definitely.
Oh, that's interesting. She says, let there be light, and she said, sayonara.
He was sophisticated, but he wasn't satisfied.
It's cool to see all these, like, cutscenes from different perspectives and
leader of the pack.
Versions.
Chaplain at Las Palmas and the man behind the abuse.
Allegedly.
Yeah, allegedly. The trapper knocked him out, cut him open, and rigged him up with explosives to blow if he moved. We got a tape of the whole thing a few days later. The sick fucker made Rominski kneel in prayer for hours, confessing his sins. When he got what he wanted, he called Sergeant Teller.
Did you know the other two cops?
That was my precinct.
So, all three of them, and you, a first responder in the botched attempt, all from the third precinct?
The murders were in our district.
How well did you know the other two? I mean, how well did you know the other first responders?
Enough to know that I didn't like them much. I got out of there as soon as possible.
Nothing different so far in this part.
The victims in each incident were just a smokescreen, and the real target was the third precinct.
Interesting.
Yeah?
These three cops, they weren't exactly best of the boys in blue.
How so?
Third precinct had problems. Of chemical variety.
They were using?
Yeah, and then some.
I'm surprised this never came up in the investigation.
I'm not. Anyways, you might have something.
What's up with you and Calvary?
No, there's a guy who's got it coming.
You couldn't even cut that tension with a chainsaw.
Yeah, that's a typo.
Calvary's just got a stick up his ass.
Why is that?
Well, for starters, I'm the one who nabbed the trapper, not him. He can't stand it.
Okay, he's had some time to get over that.
Yeah, you'd think. He keeps messing with me.
How so?
Just because I'm good at my job, I have a target on my back.
I'm sure that's not true.
Yeah, easy for you to say. My dad's not around to fight my battles for me.
No one has it easy in this town. Okay?
That was a little different. There's a lot of, like, can you imagine if a Telltale game was like this, with how it branches so drastically?
This is 125.
The problem is Telltale games are episodic. So they have to still line up with the beginning of the next episode to a degree. Well, this doesn't. This is all the same. Okay. Now, how does this play out? Because I'm not so aggressive with Calvary this time. And it's Tom. This is my partner. Man, so Carl just doesn't exist.
We got a problem.
What?
But in the other timeline, Riggs doesn't exist.
What? What happened?
I was just trying to put that together. Call came in and there was a body. Responder showed up. Body was rigged. Trap was down.
Hmm.
Police? Who? How?
It's Calvary.
What? No, that doesn't happen. That's ridiculous.
It's still sorting through the mess. Becky.
No, he didn't try to stop her there. Okay, so it's kind of, you can start seeing where things, like what factors cause what.
Excuse me, would you please stay clear of my working area? Thank you. From what we can piece together, it seems like Calvary brought a prostitute.
God.
Brought her back here where, you know.
Track her down?
Only got a partial description. 20s, brunette.
Great.
Calvary put a whole clip in that wall and didn't hit one thing. The only blood here is his. And also Montesinos.
The responder?
Calvary's body was rigged. Traps.
Fuck.
Okay, now we just need to find our pretty little evidence. Whenever it lets me. There. Nope, there. And come on, the mouse trap or rat trap. Fan of that transformer. We're all gonna die. Ah, now I want to watch Beast Wars. My childhood summed up in a show.
If someone cut his throat from behind, why would he fire this way?
Is three bullets a clip? It doesn't seem like three bullets is a clip. Isn't a clip like for a handgun like that, like 9 bullets or 8 bullets?
Really him.
Anything?
Nothing useful.
Okay, gotta be nice when Tom asks me questions here.
Sorry, but I have to ask you this. Where were you last night?
Okay, nice and easy.
I spent the night, the evening, with Felicity Graves. Going over files.
All night?
Yeah, so?
Shit.
What?
You need to be very, very careful how you handle this.
Why?
You gotta make sure you account for all your whereabouts. Everyone knows how you and Calvary felt about each other.
This is the eggshells I need to tread on carefully.
I'm not accusing you.
Oh no, but it's the first thing that pops up in there.
You can't blow up. You know what this looks like. Be smart.
Okay, not dropping the F-bomb.
I wish it wasn't.
I hated that fucker, but I would never do something like this.
I believe you.
You shouldn't have to believe me.
Okay, just keep things friendly. Ah, yes, look. The explosion. I still don't understand the point of this part.
Oh my god.
That's the end of
part. Like, what? What's the significance of setting off another explosion just for the hell of blowing up his head? I'm ready to move on. Oh, let's see. This recap's going to be different than the other ones I've done. I'm so curious. Ooh. Beck arrested Finn and saved the hostage. Beck and your partner were promoted into homicide under Sergeant Riggs. Okay. Felicity took Finn's story to Judge Vanstone. She met him at the court the same day. Felicity persuaded Judge Vanson to release Finn into police custody. Felicity invited Becky to her home to review the case files. Becky and Felicity went over the files together. Becky withheld the truth about her feud with Cavalry. Calvary. Is that withholding the truth? Becky disturbed a hidden camera at the crime scene. Becky had an alibi for the night of Calvary's murder. Calvary, yeah. Why is it so hard to say his name? Calvary.
And now, part two of Hidden Agenda.
Okay, let's see how this all plays out. What city is this even supposed to be in? I've never actually checked. Looks upstate somewhere, but I can't tell.
Hey, state Simon, of how you holding up?
Hanging in there.
A lot of extra work whenever there's a freak on the loose, I guess.
Hello, Riggs.
Okay, guys, settle down. Listen up. Hey, listen up. We lost a cop today. Another one won't be returning to active duty. And it could have been even worse. I know it's going to be tough on all of us. No one here ever thought we'd see the day that Jack Calvary went down for the count. Well, let's be blunt, he wasn't the kind to catch his flies with sugar. But he was one of us. And this atrocity cannot stand.
And what about the bomb, sir? Was it intended to kill us?
We got lucky. The blast exploded outward from the body, so when Hillary moved Calvary, the bulk of the force hit the wall.
I'm grateful I still have my hands.
Yeah, me too. Montesino's not so lucky.
So you really think this is the trapper?
Could be this Adam character. Could be the hooker. Until we have reason to believe otherwise, we are treating this as a trapper copycat. It's entirely possible that Jonathan Finn is somehow pulling the strings from behind bars.
When's it going to play into that he's in our custody?
Graves here to help with the investigation. She is familiar with the trapper's M.O. She's here to help. Please extend her every courtesy. One more thing. District Attorney Felicity Graves has negotiated to have Jonathan Finn temporarily released into our custody.
Ah, come on. You believe this?
Hey, I think this might be a valuable lead, and I'm going to follow it through. Anyone has a problem with that, you know where my office is. Detective Marnie, I'm going to need you to look into Calvary's old trapper case files. We're looking for links here, anything we could have missed.
Restrained.
Yeah, sure. Got it.
Be nice. Everything's okay, about being nice.
Just remember, Jack Calvary is watching from whatever shithole he ended up in. He's doing proud.
Hi, Miss Graves. How you holding up?
It's how tough, indeed. The ranks. No matter how it goes down. But thank you for asking. Let you know if we find anything.
They're getting ready to move Finn for his little field trip. I'd like for you to join us.
So would I. If I can get out of the dungeon.
Oh, that wasn't... that didn't happen last time.
So I've been going over it in my head.
What?
You needed an alibi for me at the crime scene. Do you really believe that I had something to do with this?
Becky.
I asked you a question.
Will you let me through, please?
Be nice.
I'm your partner. We have to be honest with each other.
Honest? Fine. Here's honest. Everybody knows about this beef between you and Calvary. Some of these guys, they don't think you're all there. You've got to start watching out for yourself.
Tom, you're accusing me of murdering a fellow officer.
You had motive. I'm just doing my job.
Meh.
You're my partner, Tom.
How can I forget?
We're supposed to be on the same side here.
I'm not on your side because I'm your partner. I'm on your side because I'm your friend.
Yeah, that's the response I wanted.
You realize. Why do you think Riggs put you on case review?
He just wants me out of the way.
Maybe. Or maybe he thinks you'll actually find something.
Ooh. There's food for thought. See, being nice works.
Adam Jones was definitely at Las Palmas, same time as Finn. Allegedly died in the fire that shut the place down. Now, according to Finn, Jones grew up to be the trapper, but how can that be possible? Doesn't make sense.
Let us go in the order I liked last time. Garbage man first.
Orderly at Las Palmas. In and out of the third precinct lockup for years, but known for his uncanny ability to avoid doing any real time. Seems likely that he knew people on the inside. If the third precinct cops were the trapper's targets, well, he connects both worlds.
Doesn't he indeed?
His brother, Vernon LeMay, works in sanitation downtown. I'm gonna pay him a visit.
Mm-hmm. Good old Vernon. Oh, he is, by the way, the same, it's the same actor that was the hunter guy in Until Dawn. With the flamethrower, the nice, helpful guy, who was kind of the opposite of this guy. He's like the one character you can't save. Well, technically, he's the one character you can't save in Until Dawn.
Like to have a little chat.
Josh is a special circumstance, I would say. I would like more games in the Until Dawn universe. Well, Inpatience in that universe, but I can't play it because I don't have PlayStation VR.
Party made foot bail.
I forgot about. Okay. And then. So there were two or just two? Okay. I guess I just remembered wrong. Again, I'm amazed how he climbs the stairs with his weird limp. So why does he carry a gun on him? That's so stupid.
Stay back. Back!
Let's be nice. Nice worked. Nice.
Mr. LeMay, listen to me. You don't want to do anything stupid, okay?
I don't gotta do anything.
No? I just want to talk to you.
What the hell you want to talk about?
Put the gun down. I just want to talk.
Calming again. I just noticed she has impeccable nail polish.
I need your help. The sooner you cooperate, the sooner this little misunderstanding will be over.
Just stay back.
Reassuring.
Okay. I'm just gonna drop my weapon. See? I only want to talk to you.
God damn it.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say.
I can.
Now, the interview process is another thing.
Let's go.
I wonder. I mean, when I went right only, it worked out fantastic. So, do I even want to risk jumbling it up? Probably don't. I probably don't want to risk that.
Ain't looking too good right now, Vernon. I guess low-life numbskull just runs in the family, huh?
What?
Quit dicking me around. This is about your brother.
Boop.
Adam Jones. What can you tell me?
Bro mentioned him once or twice. Said no matter how much he wailed on him, the kid would just look back at him. Big old dead eyes. Just taking it. Bro could do whatever he wanted, no matter how much the bastards complained. Cops weren't gonna touch their golden goose.
Why is that?
You know what? I think my mouth just got tired. I think it's time for my lawyer. I know my rights.
But
elaborate.
Want me to spell it out? He supplied. For everyone. Yeah, you're gonna send me up the river? You better make a hell of a lot of extra room.
Why is that?
Because I'm taking half the police department with me.
Yeah.
You wanna keep fucking with me?
Hey!
We're not done yet.
Hey, get this crazy bitch off of me!
Hey! Frankie! He was quite the ladies' man, huh?
What?
Always knew how to find a date.
What?
A girl!
girlfriend? Who was he seeing?
No. So this.
No. Who was he seeing, numbnuts?
No, no one. I love really. That she says numbnuts. What is that?
Well, he met some escort online. Show me some pics, like, you know, X-rated stuff. Last time I talked to him, he was setting up a date. So what, is that a crime?
Last time I checked.
Ba-bum-bum. Thank you for your time. Is she short and everyone else tall? Or are we just surrounded by very tall people? It's hard to tell. Tom, your thoughts?
Jesus, Becky. Putting on quite a show. I almost had to jump in.
Well, he was holding back. Just had to speak a language that he could understand.
Good call. This stuff about LeMay and the guys in the third precinct. Is that the one you were dealing with back then?
Mm-hmm. Teller was the ringleader over there. Kept his cards close to the chest. But I knew something was up. Why I left.
You have to tell someone about this.
No reason to dig up the dead just to drag him through the mud.
Yeah, I gotta keep that blue nice and clean, huh?
We have bigger fish now, Tom.
Everyone's happy. Everyone's still nice. We all like each other. Ugh. Pins and needles, though.
Marnie, headed to a house at 22 Huffman Road. Meet you there?
Yeah.
Oh, this didn't happen last time. We'll go into this in the next episode, so thanks for joining me. Come back, all the next stuff up real soon, but until then, bye.